Joshua Pacio claimed the one strawweight world title in Jakarta, Indonesia. He now returns to the location of his greatest triumph to defend the belt. In front of him is a Shudo world champion, Yosuke Saruta, an athletic grappler and striker from Japan. The world is set to witness an epic encounter between a youthful phenom and a crafty veteran on the 19th of January in Jakarta, Indonesia. Pacio's rise in the martial arts world has been rapid and a lesson in what is possible with dedication.
Team Lakay, ano na siya, 4 years. Na-discover ko yon nung mag-aaral na siya sa university.
His incredible ascent to the very top of the strawweight division is even more remarkable when we look further back into Pacio's life.
First of all, I was fat. When I climbed the first floor to third floor, man, I can't breathe. Just a kid wanted to lose weight. My uncle is a former Muay Thai athlete, and he introduced me to this kind of sports. That's the time I fell in love in combat sports.
Pacio soon transitioned to Wushu and began to compete, but his enthusiasm wasn't matched by his skills.
I won some, I lose some. I trained and I did a competition, I think twice, but I lost. But you know what? I enjoyed it. That's the time that I knew that this is my passion and I love to do it. That's why even though I lost my match, eager to get back and compete again.
His commitment to training and competition brought him to the attention of Mark Sankow. It changed the course of his life.
Napag-desisyonan ko na isama noon si Joshua sa Team Lakay dahil nakita ko sa kanya yung attitude talaga ng isang martial artist. Masipag, mabait, humble na bata, and makikita mo na laging sumusunod sa mga instruction.
I saw Coach Mark, Edward Falaya. I saw them also compete in local MMA promotion. I knew that I'm into it, mixed martial arts, it's my life. I was 16 or 17 years old. I'm always there, joining their conditioning. You're training with your idols, you're training with the champions. The motivation is overflowing. I learn new techniques, but also in other aspects of your life, attitude, discipline. They help me also in my studies. I got a scholarship in University of La Cordilleras.
His transition to mixed martial arts brought him instant success. Pacio went undefeated in the amateur ranks before he became a professional. And the dominant display against Yoshitaka Naito gave him the recognition he craved.
Joshua Pacio claims gold! What a moment!
With the belt strapped around his waist, Pacio begins to build his legacy. That starts with a duel with Yosuke Saruta in Jakarta. The former gymnast turned martial artist is known for his explosive movements. He made an eye-catching debut as he defeated former ONE strawweight world champion Alex Silva.
I watched his bout against Alex Silva. He's more on well-rounded athlete. He can strike, he can wrestle, and he can grapple. He's very fast shooting. I think that's the very dangerous of him. His main strength is his takedown and his grappling. Even if he takes me down, you know, I'm confident on my ground game, you know, because we're improving and we're training it. All I can see is at the end of the night, my hand will be raised.
ONE Eternal Glory on the 19th of January is set to showcase the very best athletes in the strawweight division. Joshua Pacio, determined to tighten his grip on the title and begin his legacy. Yosuke Saruta, seeks to outsmart a young king in Jakarta and take his belt back to Japan.